I have a cook shop by the name of Manny and Family, which includes my four boys. Everyone has their position. We all work together and make the cook shop possible. Yeah. This business, Manny and Family business, started practically about 2 years now. But this location is a year and a half.
So Manny, what's in your pot today?
What's in my pot today, as you can see, it's the lovely stew piece. Look at it.
It's looking good.
Perfect. You have to use a specific piece. It's the regular red piece. Some people call it kidney bean. A pound of red peas, stew, beef, a pound of pig trotters, that's pig foot, and a pound of pig tail. For a pound of peas, I use four cloves, four eggs of garlic, scallion, a little bit of ginger, a little for health purpose, a little bit of ginger, scotch bonnet pepper, and pimento seed. The pack of all-purpose Maggi seasoning that includes the spice and the lovely coconut milk. Due to the amount of pigtail, sometimes you have to scald. Cut to size, put some water, scald it a bit on the fire, come to just have a quick boil, then add to the pot. When, as long as the fork can penetrate the beef or the trotters, you add your thyme, the scotch bonnet pepper, the scallion, a small piece of ginger, your pimento, and with Maggi that completely bring it to a proper spice, we use a bit of the all-purpose and some of the luscious coconut milk. Do not wait until the meat is fully cooked, because the season needs time to also boil. And then you stay and allow it to come to a boil. A lovely waxy flavor. Prepare the stew peas. If you notice, I didn't put in all the meat at once, because you have meat that is tender more than some, easily cooked more than some. Your pigtail must not be soft. It can be easily bite, but it must not mash. There are times if the pigtail is thick, it will not be properly boiled. And if it is too thin, it will mash away in the pot. And it takes less time to cook than the trotters, the pig foot, and the beef. After adding all of that, you give a turn. You turn your pot and allow to finish boil. Then it will come to a point looking like this. It's not watery, it's luscious, it has body. As I tell you, you know, my cooking skills is hereditary, you know, and I can tell it naturally. A real cook has it in the hands. From your touch the meat nice. From your touch the veg, it nice. Naturally. It's normally serving white rice, and I had at the side, I did a tossed vegetable.
So why is your stew peas so popular here in Tel Aviv?
Because it's very good and I aim for the best.